I want to go over the lesson about how to use the C shape for every chord that there is. All the seven chords you can use the C shape. A lot of people like to use a capo when they change keys so that they can keep that comfortable C shape all the time. They can always play that C chord right there. But for the most part, what I do is I use the human capo. I just use my finger as the capo, and then I use my other three fingers to do the C shape. But I want to show how to do C shape without using no bar, no human capo, or no regular mechanical capo. No biological capo, no mechanical capo. That would be, biological would be nature, mechanical would be made out of rock, metal, salt. So all we gotta do is just do it like this. So what you gotta do is take your C chord that you play open down here and bar it up here, but instead of playing the whole thing, just play the second, third, and fourth string. That automatically sets up your fingers for the C shape right there. Although they are on three strings simultaneously, one, two, three, right next to each other, instead of the regular C shape, which would be the fifth string, the fourth string, and the second string. Just make it easy on yourself. There's the number one right there. Now the number two, if you take your bar chord up, you go one a deer, a female deer, two a drop of golden sun. You have what's called this arpeggio. The next arpeggio. And the next arpeggio. Going to be your three fingers. So when you figure it out up to neck like that, then you just take it down. It was on the second dot, one, two, second dot, one, two. So there it is, number two. And then number three is just going to be up two frets. So far we got one, two, three, and to find the four, we just go back to our regular doe deer, female deer, ray, drop of golden sun, fa, la, la, way to run. So it's this one. So we just follow the arpeggio, and there we have the four right there. And then the five is just a couple frets up. Five. So here's one, two, three, four, five. It sounds like that song that goes like this. Let's see if we can do it again. That Fleetwood Mac song. Now I'd have to look it up to find out what song it is, because I've never played that song before. But it's in my memory. I've heard it on the radio, so that when I do play the chords, I know what it is. Now all we had to do is find a sixth chord. And so the sixth chord, just go do do re mi fa so fa. So there it is. So there's the sixth chord gonna be right there. It happens to be fretting an E note, otherwise it would be down here with an open E. But we can do it right there. There it is. One, two, three, four, five, and then six. So your one, your four, and your five are on the 2-3-4 string. Your two, your three, your six are on the 1-2-3 string. And then finding the seventh note is another chord altogether. We'll cover that in another lesson.